We live in a moment where many of us are just feeling called to try to change these long ingrained patterns and create a really different future, not continue these patterns that feel so destructive to humanity, to our lives, our communities. So one way to think about this is, what are the ways that in the moment we can start to change patterns today, right here, right now? So if you imagine these patterns we've inherited, these ways of being together, ways of dealing with conflict, we can find ways, instead of just continuing those patterns, to find alternative futures that bring us to a better or a different place. So how do we change those patterns to allow a new possibility to come in? So the key thing is that we need to find ways to be in the present moment, starting to make different choices. So the first part of that is to really be present in the moment, aware of the patterns, watching what's happening, and then bringing our intention to actually creating a different pathway. So to ground it in a particular story, for example, when we come together and make collective decisions, even just at the level of one meeting room, research has shown that in that room, what tends to happen is about 75% of the input and talking is done by men, and women get their voices heard only about 25% of the time, which means that when you get to deciding something, the women's perspective, voices, input hasn't been fully incorporated, and the choice is made and things move forward without really accessing the full collective intelligence of the group. So to start to shift this pattern, for example, a real story from the Obama White House. In the first term, there were women aides and women in the rooms where decisions were being made, but a lot of the men who were in the first administration had worked on the campaign with Obama. Strong personalities, as you can imagine, lots to say, they're getting their opinions across. And the women's voices were not fully being heard. And so what the women did on their own was bring in solidarity to work together and start to say, how can we shift this? And so on their own, they decided to shift the pattern in the meeting. So whenever a woman made a comment, another one with some intention would amplify it, would name who said it and amplify and build on that comment. And they continually did this, and it started to shift how people heard the women's voices, how their voices got acknowledged, and their ideas got acknowledged, so that also the men didn't interrupt as much and didn't take their ideas and call them their own. And then by the second administration, there were many more women in the cabinet, and the rooms were more balanced. So that's one small example of how we can start to shift patterns, and we can use the same elements of presence, awareness, intention, and doing it together rather than thinking we individually need to do it. Finding where can we find solidarity to create a different future and lots more possibilities.